Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. In this video, we're going to discuss some MCQs of transport system in human being associated with lymphatic system as well as cardiovascular system. Let's move to the question number one. Question number one is, one of the following feature is not related to human circulatory system. Human circulatory system is having myogenic heart, double circuit circulation, as well as there is associated lymphatic system containing lymph as well. But hemolymph is not an associated system to the human circulation. So that's why hemolymph will be the right option. It's double circuit circulation shown over here. Question number two, average amount of blood in an adult human is of the body weight. 1/12 of the body weight is the blood in a human being. That is, you can divide the body weight of an individual by 12 to get the amount of blood in liters. Which of the following is not a compositional part of blood plasma? We know blood cells, they are not the compositional part of blood plasma. Instead, sugars, salts, plasma proteins, as well as water is found in plasma. But blood cells, they are separated and they are considered as a separate part. Which pairing of structure and function is incorrect? Erythrocytes, they are involved in oxygen transport, platelets, blood clotting, and white blood cells, they are involved in immunity, but plasma performs a variety of other functions as well. Question number five, pulse is a direct measure of heart rate of an individual, and it is the cardiac veins directly enter the right atrium of the heart. Cardiac veins, they pour their deoxygenated blood into the right atrium directly instead of inserting into the vena cava or other parts. Question number seven, which of the following transports salts, minerals, and nutrients to the body tissues? It's blood plasma, which is responsible for the transport of the various salts, minerals, and absorbed food from the intestine to the body tissues. Number eight, which of these is an incorrect statement concerning the cardiac cycle? We know that during cardiac cycle, atria contact at the same time and atrioventricular valves open at the same time, bicuspid and tricuspid valve, and they close at the same time as well. And semilunar valves, they also open and close at the same time. But right and left side, they are not contracting at the same time. We know upper and lower chambers, they contract simultaneously. So incorrect statement is delta. As you can see in this cardiac cycle, the first, the right side contract and then the left side contracts is a wrong statement over here. Question number nine, systole refers to the contraction of atrial. There may be atrial systole or ventricular systole. But out of given options, ventricles is the right option. As we know that during systolic movement, the chambers of the heart, they contract actually, either atria or the ventricles. But systolic blood pressure or systole is mainly referred to the ventricles. That's why it's the right option. Water enters capillaries on the venous end as a result of water. And water movement is never active in living tissues, and higher blood pressure in the veins, they are having lower blood pressure, and higher blood pressure on the arterial side, it's not responsible for the uptake of water. An osmotic pressure gradient can cause movement of water into the blood vessels or blood capillaries. So beta is the right option. A molecule of carbon dioxide gas that is generated in the cardiac muscle of the left ventricle would not pass through which of the following structure before leaving the body? It's left atrium. As you can see, the carbon dioxide gas which will be produced in the right, on the right side, it will move out of the lungs, and in the lungs it again gets mixed with the oxygen to get oxygenated blood. So right option over here is left atrium. Left atrium receives oxygenated blood actually. That's why carbon dioxide gas will not pass over here from the ventricles. The last step in blood clotting, as we observe the blood clotting process, There are other events as well, but the last event will be conversion of fibrinogen to the fibrin to make clots. As you can see over here, stable fibrin formation is the last step in all these pathways. Macrophages, they are derived from monocytes actually, that's why alpha. And monocytes, they stay in the blood for a few hours and then move to the tissues and form tissue macrophages. Which of the following is not a formed element of blood? As we know that leukocytes, eosinophil, platelets, they are usually found in the blood. But fibrinogen, it's blood plasma protein. So right option is Charlie. Here are some of the blood cells, white blood cells given in the list, and there are many questions which can be asked related to these blood cells at this level. For example, we can ask that which of the following are agranulocytes? As you can observe the diagram, that lymphocytes and monocytes, they do not have any granules in their cytoplasm. That's why they are agranulocytes, and right option will be delta and epsilon or E. Nucleus without any lobes or circular nucleus is found in the lymphocytes. Otherwise, monocytes are having lobe nucleus, 2 to 5 lobes in the neutrophils, bilobe nucleus in basophils and eosinophil is observed. But no lobes, they are formed within lymphocytes. So delta. Smallest in size, as you can see in the diagram, smallest cells, smallest of all white blood cells, they are actually lymphocytes. And largest, they are the monocytes, which form macrophages later on. Most common or numerous or most abundant of the white blood cells, they are neutrophils, which account almost for 62%. And least abundant, they are basophils, less than 1% in the blood. Antagonistic to each other, basophils, they produce histamine, which causes inflammation, and eosinophil, they inactivate inflammation producing substances. That's why beta and Charlie, they are antagonistic in one way. Forms macrophages, monocytes, and longest lifespan is observed by the mammary cells produced by lymphocyte B or T, so delta. And shortest lifespan is observed in monocytes, which stay for a few hours in the bloodstream and then move to the tissues, body tissues, for the formation of macrophages. And anticoagulant production is a function of basophils once again. Question number 16, which of these factors has little effect on blood flow in arteries? Heartbeat, blood pressure, total cross-sectional area, or skeletal muscle contraction? Skeletal muscle contraction is not a concerning force in the arterial force, otherwise heartbeat, heart pulse, blood pressure or total cross-sectional area, they are the accompanying factors for the movement of blood in arteries. The structure of semilunar valves of the heart shows that these valves resemble with. Semilunar valves, they resemble in their shape to the tricuspid valves. That's why right option will be Charlie. As you can see, semilunar valves of the heart, they are having structure resembling to the tricuspid valve or right atrioventricular valve. Number 18, an artery which carries blood towards the heart is coronary artery. Vena cava is not an artery. Pulmonary vein is not an artery. It's a vein. And umbilical arteries, they carry deoxygenated blood away from the placenta. That's why Charlie is the right option. Contraction of the smooth muscle layer of the arterioles. Smooth muscle layer contraction is actually vasoconstriction, which increases the frictional resistance to the blood flow in an area and reduces blood flow. It's not a way of increasing heat exchange because it reduces heat exchange. It cannot increase blood flow to the organ. It reduces blood flow, and it is not vasodilation. It is vasoconstriction. Number 20. Which of the following statement is not true? Both arteries and veins, they are having a layer of smooth muscles. Yes, it is true. Only arteries carries oxygenated blood is a wrong statement. Veins such as pulmonary vein and umbilical vein, they may also have oxygenated blood. Both arteries and veins branch out into capillary beds. Yes, they do. And pre-capillary sphincters regulate blood flow through capillaries. Yes, it happens. So right option is beta. Right answer over here. All of the following veins carry blood toward the heart except, we know, hepatic portal vein or on portal veins are those veins which carry blood towards another body organ rather than carrying blood towards the heart. So right option is delta. Here's a diagram of hepatic portal vein which is carrying blood from the digestive tract towards liver. So portal veins. One of the following set of veins carry oxygenated blood. Oxygenated blood is carried by umbilical or pulmonary veins. Otherwise, most of the veins in our body, they carry deoxygenated blood, and arteries, they usually carry oxygenated blood. But there is exception in pulmonary artery and pulmonary veins and umbilical artery and umbilical veins. Strongest chamber of the heart is left ventricle, which pushes the blood, pumps the blood towards body tissues. That's why right option is delta. Pulse can be observed in arteries. And an ECG measures changes in electrical potential during the cardiac cycle. And they're shown in the form of a graph, electrocardiogram. The lymphatic system is like the circulatory system in that they both have nodes? No. Nodes are found in lymphatic system only. Have a network of arteries? No. Arteries are the structural feature of circulatory system only. And capillaries? No. But they are both closed systems. So right option is delta. Pre-capillary sphincter to regulate blood flow are found in arterioles, met arterioles of the type which are having pre-capillary sphincters to regulate blood flow. Highest blood pressure is found in aorta and lowest blood pressure is observed in vena cava. So right option is alpha. Falling blood pressure with maximum cross-sectional area is a characteristic feature of blood capillaries. Another question can be associated with the same options and same answer as well. The difference between systolic and diastolic pressure, it diminishes at capillaries. And highest cross-sectional area is also observed over here with falling blood pressure. A wave which occurs before atrial depolarization is P wave. QRS wave, QRS complex, it depicts ventricular depolarization, and T wave is ventricular repolarization. Largest lymphoid mass in the lymphatic system is spleen. As you can see, it exists just above the kidneys. Thymus gland is another larger lymphoid mass, and tonsils as well as adenoids, they are also considered as lymphoid masses. Which of the following provides a force for lymph flow? Movement of viscera, visceral organs, and movement of skeletal muscles, as well as breathing movements, semilunar valves, they are all helping or assisting factors for the flow of lymph in lymphatic system. So delta is the right option. Lymph nodes, they are usually not found in brain, but they are abundantly present in axillary region as well as groin or inguinal region, but they are absent from the brain. 34. Graveyard of red blood cell is spleen, and contractile layer of the heart is myocardium. Here are some of the questions. Myocardium is the thickest layer as well, which possesses cardiac muscles, which are responsible for the contraction of heart. Some of the questions have been taken from UHS 2019 and NMBCAR 2020 paper. Which of the following blood vessel contains semilunar valve? Right option is vein. Just like lymphatic system, they possess semilunar valves to prevent backward flow of the blood, but there are no semilunar valves in the arteries. Largest lymph vessels ultimately forming larger lymph ducts which drains lymph into subclavian vein is the most repeated question in past papers with reference to lymphatic system. The subclavian vein, it carries the whole lymph towards heart on the left side. The major function of basophil is to release heparin to prevent blood clotting. And NBK 2020, it also includes some questions related to this part, like regarding structure of the human heart, chordae tendineae, they are found or present in the ventricles. As you can see, chordae tendineae, they are the fibrous structures found in the ventricles responsible for the attachment of bicuspid and tricuspid to the walls of ventricle through papillary muscles. The only vein in the human body carrying oxygenated blood is pulmonary vein. The other veins which carry oxygenated blood, they are found at embryonic stages. They are umbilical. Which of the following blood vessels have the highest pressure of the blood? It is aorta, as we have observed in the previous question as well. And in human heart, the left atrium receives the four pulmonary veins, coming two coming from the right side, right lung, and two coming from the left lung. So that was all about discussion of circulatory system and its important questions with reference to NMBCAT 2021 paper. Thank you so much. Thank you for listening. Allah Hafiz.